Recording mis primeros éxitos was a really different experience, I guess, not only for myself, but for Suzette, Selena, my dad, and the rest of the guys. Recording an album for an unknown group is always a thrill. And for us, it was always a thrill to go into the studio and record. We recorded the majority of these songs off of Mis Primeros Éxitos at a little studio in San Antonio that actually was a garage made out of tin, almost like a tin roof type, which was normally supposed to be used on the roof, was used to decorate the whole outside of the building. It was a real different experience for us. I'll never forget those days, the recording techniques and just everything. It was pretty much very primitive. But a lot of great artists, Tejano artists, walked through the doors of that studio. We were real fortunate to be a part of that era in time when Tejano music was just blossoming and just exploding.
Hello, I'm Abraham. Mis Primeros Éxitos was an album that we recorded. It was like kind of a recap of what we had done prior to joining up with EMI Latin. And what we done is we took some of the songs that we had recorded pre-EMI and done different arrangements on them and, you know, put them on a new album.
On Mis Primeros Éxitos, these are songs that were recorded way before we even were signed with EMI Latin. It brings back a lot of memories of when we first started out. And I believe most of these songs were not with Pete or Joe. Yeah, I think Pete and Joe joined the group after this album, which was the first album. I think they first recorded on the Selena album.
If I had to pick one song off of Mis Primeros Éxitos, I would have to say, you'd have to allow me to, because one of my favorites is Tú No Sabes, which was written by Ricky Vela. It's a mariachi style song, really, really pretty song. Or Costumbres by Juan Gabriel, which is an excellent song, and Selena just really sang it real pretty.
I really, really like a song that was written by Ricky, titled Tú No Sabes. If I'm not mistaken, it was the first mariachi-flavored song that we had recorded with Selena.
When I wrote Tú No Sabes, I had it in my mind to do it as a slow mariachi-type song. And AB wanted to do it as a cumbia, so he arranged it as a cumbia in practice. Eventually, the other one won out. I don't know why, but I think even AB still prefers the cumbia version that we practiced. The song came out real nice. Selena sang it with a lot of feeling.
If I had to pick one song that I would have to say was a typical song describing Selena y Los Dinos at the time these songs were recorded, I would have to say Dame Un Beso would be a great example of where we were at that time. Eventually, we would go from playing rancheras or Tejano to playing cumbias.
Dame Un Beso was really good. I like Dame Un Beso on Mis Primeros Éxitos. Ah, but then there's Cariño, Cariño Mío.
Yo Fui a Kid, that was one of the first songs that AB wrote. It was back in the early days. I remember he was real proud of it. Well, I liked it too, so. AB wrote the melody for Yo Fui a Kid right away, real easily, but like he was kind of like me having to figure out words. So over the course of a few days, he worked the words out, and it came out nice. Quiero Estar Contigo. Originally, it was called Evangelina. Instead of it being Quiero Estar Contigo, it was Evangelina. I was real happy when we recorded Cien Años. I was happy about it because, I mean, it was a song I'd heard since I was a little boy, because my dad used to like to listen to a lot of Pedro Infante type songs, and that was a real big hit, I guess, from way back then. And she sang it real cool.
Para los fanáticos de Selena y Los Dinos, esto que se está haciendo de 20 años de música de Selena y Los Dinos es algo que es un labor de amor. Lo estamos haciendo para todos los fans, los fanáticos de Selena, para todos los coleccionistas, y los invitamos que lo escuchen.